Hi, do you know what is the most searched query on Google? It's not IPL or Bollywood. It is, what is wrong with me? Yes, it's Google before doctors. But hey, do you really want to take the word of someone who may not know any better than you and me? I'm Vineetha Athrey. I'm a journalist and an author, and I welcome you to Mallige Answers, where I catch up with renowned doctors from Mallige Hospital to answer questions on health and well-being. Join me. Hello and welcome to Mallige Answers. I'm Vineetha Athrey and I'm in conversation with renowned surgeon Dr. Shivshankar Sastry. Hello, doctor. Let's say if there is a surgery involved, may or may not be an amputation, but even a small surgery involved, say a part of the toe has to go. What sort of complications can this lead to, and how does a caregiver take care of the patient in a way that those complications are reduced?
Yeah, I need to point out that almost 100% of patients with diabetic feet require some surgery. That does not mean they have to get admitted. It may get done right there.
Okay.
The basic thing would be to remove some pus. It may not be removal of a toe or anything like that. So 100% of, and in fact, almost in every visit, they may have a continuation of minor bits of surgery where bits of dead tissue, sometimes even a bit of dead bone has to be removed.
So what should one do as post-operative care to prevent complications?
See, the worst complication, of course, in a diabetic foot is it won't heal.
Yeah.
Yeah, if it doesn't heal and the infection keeps spreading, this is a problem. And the only way to treat it is to persist, keep the diabetes under control, control the infection.
Feet kind of take care of the entire body weight, and if one or two toes are gone, does it cause problems with redistribution of the body weight, and does that lead to additional stress for the feet, and how should one take care of that?
That's an absolutely valid question, because after all, you have five toes and you have a foot, and the five toes and the foot normally bear all your weight when you're walking. Now if you remove one toe or two toes, you're removing at about 10%. So your entire body weight is now going on the remaining 90%. So each of that part, which probably already has neuropathy, is taking more weight. So the chances of getting yet another infection are very high.
Right.
And this is where the person has to be doubly careful in wearing protective socks, wearing protective shoes, not trying to walk barefoot, and making sure that the foot is cared for adequately.
Is grafting something you consider actively for these patients?
By grafting, I presume you mean skin grafting.
Right, because you mentioned non-healing. So one way of preventing that could be to do a little bit of skin grafting so the recovery becomes faster.
Yeah, there are certain situations where skin grafting is feasible. Basically, you need a nice area that's already healing and not infected. See, there are different types of skin grafting. Typically, the simplest one would be what is called as a split skin grafting, or a half thickness skin grafting, where you take half the thickness of skin from somewhere and put it on that. But for that skin to survive, that area has to be already healing. Once it gets more complex than split thickness grafting, if it requires something more complex, I would normally ask one of my plastic surgery colleagues to handle it.
Thanks, doctor. Keep watching Mallige Answers. We will come back and continue discussing diabetic foot.